Hi, this is Brian, a meteorologist here at your National Weather Service forecast office in Medford, Oregon. When the days get shorter and the temperatures begin to cool, we begin to hear the word inversion more and more often when discussing the forecast for our area. Let's discuss what the inversion is and how it affects our weather. Normally, temperatures are warmer at the surface and get cooler as altitude increases. However, sometimes cold air can settle at the ground, and the warmer air is actually above the surface, layered between cooler air both above and below. When this situation occurs, it is called an inversion. Now let's place this scenario into a valley. Under normal conditions, with the warmest temperatures at the surface, the air in the valleys can rise and sink, and winds blowing above the mountains can reach into the valleys. This process is known as mixing, and it keeps the air moving between the valleys and the rest of the atmosphere. In essence, it keeps the air refreshed. But when colder air settles into the valleys, an inversion can form. This usually occurs when high pressure dominates the weather. The high pressure pushes down on the air, keeping the air within the valley from being able to rise up and out. If there is enough moisture within the air in the valley, and depending on the depth of the inversion, clouds or fog can form. This shades the valley but leaves the higher elevations clear. What winds do blow above the valley cannot reach the air inside and merely blow over the top of the mountain ridges. This scenario can last for days until a strong system can sweep through and remove the inversion, allowing the normal mixing process to resume. This satellite image shows fog within the valleys of southwestern Oregon. The Rogue Valley is socked in at Grant's Pass, but is only partially filled into the Medford area. Note the tops of the Table Rocks are visible while the surrounding valley floor is not. There is also some fog in the Umpqua Valley near Roseburg and in the smaller valleys near Canyonville and Myrtle Creek. The phenomenon can make for some interesting views from the surrounding mountains, with the valleys appearing as large bowls filled with marshmallow fluff or cotton balls. All of the previous processes occur naturally, but what happens when we add the human effects? When the air in the valley becomes trapped under an inversion, all the smoke and particulate from factories, fires, auto exhaust, and other human productions becomes trapped in the valley as well. Over time, these pollutants build up, and left unchecked, the valley becomes filled with bad quality air. Again, any winds overhead cannot reach the air in the valley, and until the next system sweeps the area clear, the valley remains stagnant. In short, the inversion can lead to rising levels of pollutants and deteriorating air quality. If the inversion lasts long enough, and production of pollutants is not kept to a minimum, the air under the inversion can become very unhealthy. And those are the processes behind the inversion. Thanks for watching. As always, for up-to-date forecasts and current conditions, visit your National Weather Service at www.weather.gov/medford.